Ready to take the video quality on your Facebook Live to the next level? I'm going to talk about that in today's video blog. Hi there, internet fans. Ryan Perry here, CEO of Simple Biz Support, and I help business owners harness the power of video in order to grow their business online. And today I want to talk about Facebook Live. Let's face it, with everything going on, so many people are going live, maybe YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, there's all kinds of stream. Even LinkedIn is coming out with a live service shortly. But today specifically, I want to talk about Facebook. Pretty much everybody, hopefully at this point, knows how to go live on their smartphone. And if you're one of those people who have a really nice, you know, $1,000 plus smartphone, probably rocking out pretty well with that device. However, if you're still using a webcam, I want to show you how to use a Canon DSLR camera as a webcam and get really phenomenal video quality. In order to do that, we actually need to jump into the office onto the computer so I can show you how to set that up to go Facebook Live on your Canon DSLR. All right, welcome to Facebook and my computer. In order to improve the quality of your feed, your live Facebook video, what you're going to need to do is connect your Canon camera to the computer. And I recommend doing this via USB. One, it's going to be a lot less inexpensive, as far as you do not have to buy a video card or some sort of USB to HDMI card that's a couple hundred dollars. And the fact that Canon, in fact, I've got a video right here if you'd like to watch it on Facebook, Canon has downloaded their beta version of their EOS webcam utility. You can download this and then you would connect the camera via USB to your computer. Or the other option, and the one I'm going to use today, is going to be SparkleCam. Now, SparkleCam was the option back in the day before Canon came out with their product for connecting your Canon to your PC via USB. Now, for me, I like SparkleCam. The downside to SparkleCam is that it is $70. However, they do have a free version at SparkleCam.com. And the one thing that I really like about SparkleCam is the fact that once you install the software, which I'm not going to show you how to do here, is that you do have control over the camera. In fact, you could have a couple of different cameras plugged in and you could pick and choose which one you would like. You also have remote access. So if you want to click a picture, I could take a picture right now, but I can see what my exposure is. I can see what my shutter speed is. My ISO, all of that is here, and I'm able to do that all right here through the software. I don't have to reach around the camera somehow in order to make a change. The other thing, if you're into it, SparkleCam has all kinds of fun features. I'm not sure what that color was. Oh, it actually adds a little color. Thank you. See how, look how washed out I am here. So that's why I have the color feature on. But you can do text overlays. They have images. You can do green screen. They have face accessories. You know, I could put some hair on here. This is all kind of some of the goofy stuff that if you wanted to do, you could do. For business, though, the main reason why I like it is that I'm able to connect. I get a high quality signal, but I can actually can control the camera and make adjustments as needed. In order for SparkleCam to connect with Facebook Live, you do need to have the software open. So right now, I'm just going to move this over to my other screen. So you have two options, Canon, SparkleCam. Canon is free. However, it is beta version. I've run into a couple of issues, and that's why I'm currently not using it. Plus, it doesn't give you any flexibility like the SparkleCam does. So let's walk through what you're going to do. What you're going to want to do is go up and click on Live to create a new broadcast. From here, I want to use my camera. So this is going to be streaming directly out of my Canon 80D. However, if you are using OBS or some other type of broadcasting software, you can go ahead and use the stream key. And in that case, this video is pretty much mute. I'm going to go ahead, click the camera. What's interesting here is I'm getting an error that says I don't have the most updated version of Chrome, which I don't have an update indicator over here. So I'm not sure what's going on. At this point, Facebook is going to switch me back to their old version of Go Live. Not a problem. Up top, go ahead, click on camera here, and they're asking me to try Live Producer, which is the new version, which won't work, and it just doesn't work very well. So we're going to dismiss this. Boy, I don't look good. I wonder why that is. Oh, I know why that is. This is on my Logitech C920. This is a really nice webcam as far as webcams come. It's probably better than most smartphones, and it's going to be better than most built-in cameras on a lot of laptops and Chromebooks. However, the quality just isn't that good. So what we're going to do, next to the camera icon over here on the right-hand side, you have a new option here called the SparkoCam Virtual Camera. Go ahead and click on that unit, and here you are. Now we are ready to go live with the Canon. And let me just switch it back real quickly again. It looks washed out. I don't have the bokeh in the background, that blurred, that really nice looking. The colors are just desaturated. Not excited. So let's go back to SparkoCam. And to me, this looks much, much better. And if you plan on going live on a regular basis, why not take one of your Canons that's been sitting around, plug in a USB cable, set it up on a tripod, you don't need to hold it, and get rocking and rolling with your live feed. If you have any questions, comments, whatever it might be, feel free to leave those below. I always appreciate it if you leave a like, if you enjoyed this and found it valuable. And if you want more information, feel free to subscribe. Until next time, everybody, hope you have a great day.